Welcome back, nerds. Today we are going to have a class on the types of learning. The major types of learning we have already discussed in our previous class. In this class, we will look at the other types of learning. So let's begin. The first type of learning is observational learning. It is learning that occurs through observing the behavior of others. The process of social learning takes various forms, and it is based on a variety of factors. Humans do not require reinforcement for this form of learning but do require a social model, such as a parent, sibling, friend, or teacher. Active learning is another type of learning where a person takes charge of their learning experience, known as active learning. Learning involves understanding information, so learners must recognize what they understand and do not understand. By doing so, they can monitor their own mastery of subjects. Another important type of learning is episodic learning. In this type of learning, a behavior change occurs due to an event. Here, episodic learning involves fear of dogs resulting from being bitten by a dog. Another learning type is enculturation. It is the process by which people learn values and behaviors that are appropriate or necessary in their surrounding culture. Learning through play and sports. Multimedia learning happens when a person uses auditory and visual stimuli to learn information. Imprinting can also be a type of learning process. It is learning at a particular life stage that is rapid and independent of the consequences of behavior. Another type of learning is e-learning and augmented learning. One of the important learning types is rote learning. The process of memorizing information so that it can be recalled by the learner precisely as it was read or heard. Meaningful learning is a concept that learned fact or knowledge is fully understood to the extent that it relates to other knowledge. Evidence-based learning or education or simply EBE learning. It uses evidence from well-designed scientific studies to accelerate learning. The principle of evidence-based education states that education practices should be guided by scientific evidence rather than tradition or personal judgment. Evidence-based education relates to evidence-based teaching, learning, and school effectiveness research. Formal learning occurs within a teacher-student relationship, such as in a school system. Nonformal learning is the process outside of a formal educational setting. An excellent example would be interacting with people with similar interests and exchanging viewpoints in clubs, youth organizations, and workshops. Informal learning is less structured than nonformal. An individual may acquire this skill through the experience of day-to-day situations. Learning in an informal setting can take many forms, such as watching videos, studying on your own, reading articles, participating in forums and chat rooms, receiving performance support, and engaging in coaching sessions. In tangential learning, people self-educate when they are exposed to a topic in an environment they are already familiar with. For example, some people may be motivated to learn after playing a music-based video game. Dialogic learning is a type of learning based on dialogue. Concept-based learning or question or teaching. It is a comprehensive guide that provides students with concepts, content, and skills for a deep understanding of all subjects. This guide combines proven curriculum design with proven teaching methods. Content-based instruction or learning or simply CBI learning. It is a practical approach to language education. It is a method of teaching second languages in which students will acquire content or information. It is organized around the content rather than a linguistic or another syllabus. problem-based learning, or simply PBL. This method involves students learning about a subject by solving an open-ended problem. So that's all for today. In our next class, we will discuss the characteristics of learners. So don't miss that class and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in our next class.